All right, Tana, this will be a little bit of a hack for you, so 5 to 7 minutes. So everybody, my name is Melody Chambers, and I'm here to teach you a simple hack on creating a speech that's efficient and with impact. My assignment today is to organize a speech well, and I thought it would be fitting to teach you all a tool that on how to do that while I do my speech. I used this when I was a speaker for United Way of King County, and once I show you this technique, you're never going to look at speech writing the same way again. So first of all, if public speaking is scary, imagine that your first try at public speaking is to go out to workplaces, high-profile workplaces, and ask people for money. And you're representing an organization whose sole income is from fundraising, no pressure. And you have to go in where there's attorneys, Fortune 500 companies, and make a short, efficient speech with impact. So that's obviously what happened with me. So fortunately, they did teach us a little shortcut while I was at United Way of King County, and I'm going to pass that on to you. So the average person places the fear of public speaking above death. The last thing you want to do is to appear unorganized. And the worst thing that can happen is you stand in front of a group and not know what to say. Lots of factors can work to your detriment. You can have short notice. You can have lack of familiarity with the topic, or you can just have lots of things happening at the same time. These items come up in lots of scenarios. At Toastmasters in the business world, you may be required to lead a meeting on short notice. If your business knows that you're a Toastmaster, they'd be like calling on you to do some things. You may be asked to say a few words for a giving campaign, or you may just be even called to do a speech in front of a large room. You just never know. Implemented well, public speaking can actually enhance the image and credibility of the speaker. It feels great when you have a good, well-organized speech, right? And just from having a good speech, the speaker can be viewed as an expert, they can be viewed as an authority figure, or they can be viewed as an influencer. People who are viewed as influencers are more likely to be promoted. And I want all of us to have that experience with speech writing. So who wants to find this out and create a speech, how to write the speech in 10 minutes or less? All right, good group. All right, so the model I'm about to show you is simple and easy to remember. It's taken from the SPIN selling model, and SPIN stands for, S is situation, P is problem, I is implication, and N is need payoff. And I just used this method on you with my speech. So I'm going to show you how I did that. So the situation is the opening. So you're introducing yourself and providing a brief summary of why you're here. So mine was, hi, my name is Melody Chambers. I'm here to teach you a simple hack for crafting a speech efficiently. To use it in another situation, like an employee giving campaign, you might say, I'm here to talk about United Way and how we work with the community to solve problems. The problem that came next, and here you outline the problem without the solution. So with speaking, the problem is appearing unorganized or not knowing what to say. In the United Way campaign speech, I might say that we have the highest youth drug problem in Washington State. And that actually is true. What we often tend to do is go straight to solution when we talk with people and when we do speeches. The first thing that we want to do is just stand up there and say, hi, I'm Melody, I'm going to solve all your problems today. I've got this solution, and this solution. But when you look at great communicators, they often spend more time on the problem and outline that really well before they go into the solution because it has more impact. You can take your cues from the As Seen on TV commercials, where they start out with the poor hapless person in the kitchen and they say, has this ever happened to you? And they have the mustard and they get squirted all over them and the spatula jabs them in the side. They spend a lot of time on that before they go into solution. It's kind of tongue in cheek, but your audience is not going to identify with you or be open to receiving the information that you have to give them until and unless they feel that you fully understand them and fully understand their problem. So next is implication. Here is where you imply how great it would be to solve the problem. In my example, it was talking about how public speaking can enhance your image if you do it well. With the United Way example, it would be with teen drug abuse. Studies show that when you intervene early on in an addiction, your chances of changing that child's life increase by 70%. So you start to feel like, wouldn't it be great if we could solve that problem? And then finally is need payoff. Now it's time for the solution. After you've gone through all that and structured it so that your audience is following along with you, you've established the need and the solution makes sense. So for my example, the need payoff was the explanation of the spin model. And in the other example with United Way, the need payoff was you can make a difference in the community by giving to United Way. So that's it. I hope that next time when you're stumped with creating a speech, you'll remember the spin method and create one, an outline in 10 minutes or less.